guys, how about a science experiment?
It's time for a science experiment.
We haven't done one of these in a while, and I found a great website with a few science experiments that I wanted to try out on, so this is the first one of the few that I found. This one was titled in the website, Blobs in a Bottle, or I'm gonna call it, How to Make a Homemade Lava Lamp. We need some kind of funneling device, pieces of paper is what I'm gonna use, the oil, vegetable oil or canola oil, food coloring, Alka-Seltzer, 3/4 cup of water, and a bottle. So the first thing you wanna do is pour your water into the bottle. Now what you want to do is take your funneling device, in my case some hard sheets of paper, I took two just kind of give it a little bit of durability, hopefully it works, so I don't have a funnel, and put that on top of your bottle here. Once you have that in, pour your oil in almost to the top of the bottle. Alright, we want to make sure that the water and the oil has separated pretty cleanly, which it looks like it has. And then you want to take your food coloring. What color do we want to do? What color? How about red? I like red. And we're going to put about 10 drops of food coloring into our mixture here. So it looks pretty cool coming down through there.
I don't know if y'all can see, but it's just kind of sitting on the bottom there, and sooner or later it's gonna bust through and mix with the water.
Alright, looks like we got some redness on the bottom there now, looking good. A few more drops up there that we're waiting on. There we go, that was a beautiful one. Nice. Now that the food coloring has started to mix with the water there, I'm just gonna kinda turn it just to kinda get the mix going. And now what you wanna do is take your Alka-Seltzer, open that up, grab a tablet, break it in half, and put that into the bottle. That's so cool! So as you guys know, water and oil do not mix together because the oil is less dense than the water, otherwise known as intermolecular polarity. Let's put the other half in. So what's happening here is the gas that's being released from the Alka-Seltzer is being pulled up through the oil with some of the red food coloring, thus creating these bubbles in the container that come up through the oil to release the gas finally out of the bottle. Are you curious to know what happens if you cap off the bottle? There's a little bit of air building up in here. I don't know if y'all could hear that. The little bit of gas that was created here, I needed some place to go, and so it was just containing up near, is building pressure. Whenever I let go, I heard a little pfft. Are y'all ready to go insane? Who's ready for this? Let's put 6 tablets in there and see what happens. That's so awesome! If you want more videos from me, please click that subscribe button up there. If you want to see some behind the scenes footage of this video, make sure to go and check out my vlogging channel, youtube.com/thefunnyrats. And if you like what you see over there, please subscribe. I definitely appreciate it.